Thank you for staying with me on Crunch Econometrics. This is the 8th video of our GMM video tutorials. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can generate long-run GMM coefficients only for the significant short-run coefficients. So generate long-run coefficients only for those coefficients that are significant in the short run. So we are back in Stata. Always remember to have your log file on to track whatever you are going to do. You can easily repeat your estimations. And here is our data editor, still using the same data characteristics. 54 countries, Algeria being country 1, and Zimbabwe as country 54. By now, you know that each country has 11 years observations from 2005 to 2015. And to control for time dimension in the data, I have generated 11 years dummies. So always have year dummies whenever you want to run a panel data regression. Here is the do file with the code. This do file will be made available on my website, so please make sure you have a Google account and a Chrome browser so you can easily download this Stata do file. So all the codes are written out, you can see. So all we need to do is to first run the regression, this one, after which we run this code to generate the long-run coefficients. So let's get to it. Let me run this. This is a two-step system GMM syntax. Here is the Stata output for that, two-step system GMM. And if you have been following my tutorial, you will observe that this is the same output that we used when we were discussing how to interpret GMM results. This shaded portion is our main focus when you want to generate long-run coefficients. So we are only concerned about these three coefficients, and that is because they are the only significant short-run coefficients. So these are the coefficients that we are going to generate the long-run coefficients for. Once a coefficient is not significant, just discard it. It's not up for any discussion. So concentrate only on significant short-run coefficients. So now we can see that inflation, internet use, and mobile are all significant in the short run. Inflation has a negative impact in the short run, significant at the 5% level. Internet use has a positive short-run relationship, significant at the 10% level. And mobile also has a significant short-run coefficient, significant at the 5% level. So once again, we are only interested in generating long-run coefficients for these significant short-run coefficients. So let's go back to our do file. So here are the syntax for the long-run coefficients. Let's look at the syntax closely. Remember, inflation is significant in the short run. Internet use is also significant, and mobile also significant in the short run. So you are going to use those coefficients, divide it by 1 minus the coefficient of the lagged dependent variable. That is a computation. So you can say the same thing for internet usage. The coefficient for internet divided by 1 minus the coefficient of the lagged dependent variable, and same thing for the log of mobile. So here on the screen, we have the long-run coefficients for the three significant short-run coefficients. This is for the first one, inflation. This is for internet use, and here for mobile. Looking closely at the Stata output for long-run coefficients, the first thing you will observe that we have Z statistics instead of T, but it doesn't lose its interpretation, okay? Just go straight to the p-values and see whether they are significant or not. For instance, inflation, though has a significant short-run relationship, we can see that in the long run, it is no longer significant. So you can mention that when you are discussing your results, that in the short run, inflation has a significant negative relationship, but on the long run, it is no longer a significant relationship. Let's look at internet use, significant at the 5% level. So you can also say that in the short run, inflation has a significant relationship with economic growth, and same thing in the long run. Let's look at mobile, also significant in the long run. Same interpretation, mobile has a significant short-run and long-run relationship with economic growth. So this is how you can generate long-run coefficients for the significant short-run coefficients. So all you have to do is to extract each of these figures one after the other and put them neatly in a table and just discuss the results. So this is what I just displayed in Stata. These are the short-run coefficients for the two-step system GMM estimations. So just give the usual ceteris paribus interpretation like I showed you in the previous video. Concentrate only on the significant short-run coefficients. Just like I showed you right now in Stata, these are the long-run coefficients, which we generated only for the significant short-run coefficients. How do you interpret? Simply give the usual ceteris paribus interpretation. And this is the mathematical computation for the long-run coefficients. If you need to put this in your manuscript, that is fine. Just to show your reviewer or your supervisor that you know exactly what you are doing. This is the mathematical computation of how we arrived at the long-run coefficients. So how do you interpret this? For instance, let us interpret the results for mobile. So the long-run effect of mobile subscription on economic growth is positive with a coefficient of 0.79. What does this mean? It means a percentage change in mobile subscription is associated with a 0.79% increase in economic growth in the long run at the 1% significance level on average ceteris paribus. Hence, mobile subscription and economic growth exhibit an inelastic relationship. So by now, you understand what I mean by an inelastic relationship. This was discussed in the video under interpreting GMM outputs. And you can also continue the discussion by saying mobile subscription has a larger positive effect on economic growth in the long run than in the short run. So this one will tell your readership that you understand exactly what you are talking about. So this is how to generate long-run estimates for any GMM outputs. Just restrict the estimates to the significant short-run coefficients. The final video will be to plot year dummies in any GMM output. Thank you for watching. Thank you for the support. Thank you for the feedback. Kindly share my videos with your cohorts, your students, and academic community. In case you have not subscribed to my channel, please do so. Crunch Econometrics is dedicated to beginners and intermediate users. Please don't go away. I'll be right back.